Hey friends, so right off the bat, let's address the suitcases in the room instead of the elephant in the room. I'm so funny. Anyway, these suitcases are about ready to be zipped up. Zach and I are gonna take another look at them, make sure we've got everything we need in them, and then these bad boys are getting zipped up and thrown in the car. Where are we going? We are going to Iowa. We're gonna be leaving here in a little bit. We're gonna take off on a 24-hour drive that's gonna bring us to Iowa. While Zach is sleeping, I'll be driving. While Zach is driving, I'll be sleeping. That's how we roll, that's how we like it. We're looking forward to this drive. We look forward to it every time we make the drive. And this time especially, we're looking forward to it because we're gonna try a little bit different route. I'm not exactly sure what Zach has planned, but he did tell me it's gonna be different this time. So, why are we going to Iowa? We are going to Iowa to visit our daughter, our parents, our siblings, our nieces and nephews, our friends, and so it's gonna be awesome. But even with all that awesomeness, I'm gonna be missing you guys because we are going to miss church. We are going to church with you. We're going to be missing Oasis. We're going to be missing some other fun things that are going to be happening this week and this coming weekend. So, I will be missing you, but I'm so grateful that God has put on our hearts to be in devotion together, to set aside this time every day where you on your end and me on my end are going to be reading his word, we're going to be praying to him, and we're going to be reading through this devotion. And again, our devotion is called Psalms for Lent. So what is the Lenten psalm that we are going to hit on today? Psalm 25. And the focus, the topic for today is truth. Psalm 25:5 says, "Lead me in your truth and teach me." Now the author of our devotion says, if you're as old as I am, you recall Lily Tomlin's character, Edith Ann, who often ended her rocking chair monologues by saying, "And that's the truth." There she was in character as a 5.5-year-old who utterly believed that whatever she said was the truth. Our world has turned into a place where many have their own version of the truth. If they say it, it must be true. In Psalm 25, David is hemmed in on all sides. If he had his way, God would defeat his enemies right then and there. That would have been his version of truth. But he doesn't ask for his way. He asks to be shown God's way. He asks to be led in God's truth. Sometimes the way to truth means humbly setting aside our own way for what God shows us is his way. No ifs, ands, or buts. Let's pray. Lenten Lord, take our hand and lead us. Teach us in the way of your truth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Oh my goodness, that was a good one. Okay, now we are going to read Psalm 25, all of it. And then we're going to read John 14, 1 through 7. You will not be disappointed. I don't think I will either. Bye, friends.